Logan. Logan.
Animal training, and this is my personal 40-foot zoo. Let me take you around for a quick look. Zoo. Let me take you around for a quick look. Where I'm located here is in BC, Canada, down on the Fraser Valley. So I'm in a perfect countryside to hunt pigeons to feed my ferrets. Here's Fiona down here. There's Toast back there. Logan's over by the window over there. We'll go inside. And then there's Avocado pulling through the middle here. They're in approximately 5 foot by 10 foot, so 50 square foot room with, like, God knows how much money I've spent on scratch posts in here. Probably close to $800 on everything I spent. I grow my own ferret food. Like, I've got some basil, some radishes, some thyme. And then there's some kale, watercress, some mustard greens, onions, some more radishes, some broccoli. I'm not sure what I planted here, but I know it was all bird safe. I try to recycle everything and make good use of the space I have here. These pallets I paid nothing for, and they were perfect as planters, so. Let me take you inside now. All right, as you come in the door here, you turn to the right, you got the ferret backpacks. I also use them for the birds when need be. So you got Toast over there, you got Logan, Fiona, and Avocado. They have the water dish right here, and I feed them raw, and they basically get fed once a day. Whatever doesn't get eaten the first day gets left over for breakfast the next day. They never really go more than 5 hours without food in there. This is Whiskey Jack, our puppy. He's like, what are you talking to yourself? Hey, buddy. Talk? No? Oh. He's a good boy. Good boy. Alright, in here we have the water fountain for the bird bath. I've seen people use these for... Sorry for the mess, I just had dinner. I've seen people use these for ferrets. I don't suggest them for ferrets because fur could get into the pump and then clog it and then you'd have a water overflow. Not really smart. Over in this, we have a sugar glider for now. Just one. We're getting a female on tomorrow, really. So look out for that video. Subscribe if you haven't already. We have sugar gliders in this cage where we're going to do a breeding setup. We have an Asian pear tree that's dying due to root rot because I didn't know to put pebbles in the bottom. Always do your research before you get into a new hobby such as growing. You learn from your mistakes. This is my fish tank that grows my bamboo for my birds. My UV light so the plants have their UV light to grow, photosynthesize and whatnot. The walls decked out for decor for the birds. Archery equipment, because I'm an archer, whatever. Yes, basically the overview of my place. This is a rent-free place, by the way. I'm probably going to mention it in my title. I don't have to pay for power. I don't have to pay for internet. It's just the internet cuts out a lot, but you take what you get. And in here, sorry for the bird poop. He did that today. Is Echo. And then we have Jazz. Echo. I'll go in. So we got Butter up here, Joey over there, and Ducky right there. Jasmine's a female, I believe, lovebird. I believe she's female because her legs are spread pretty wide apart. And Echo, I believe, is a male. I have no idea. Probably gonna end up being a female because I say that. But he's my son Conier I've had for a year. I basically rescued him because he was not going to get rehomed. He was never able to come out of his enclosure. So basically, he would be left in this fish tank. And whenever people would stick their hands in, he would bite. So he's never came out of that fish tank until I met him. I stuck my hand in. He didn't bite. He just jumped up onto me. I didn't force him to get up like most people do by putting your finger underneath the bird. Echo, come here. He's like, Dad. He doesn't want to fly to me right now for some reason. The other ones do. Basically, Echo was locked in his cage, unable to come out. He stepped up onto me like this, And then he crawled up all the way to my shoulder, if you could demonstrate. Demonstrate climbing to my shoulder? He's like, nah. Too interested in my watching me. But basically, he crawled up to my face, started kissing me. I thought he was going to bite me. But he kissed me. And I asked how much would it be for a down payment. Because I wasn't going to just let him be there in a cage where he's not able to come out. And he picked me right off the bat. Because he did this. And I was scared. I'm like, well, is he going to bite my ear? I was just told he's aggressive. He's like, yeah, I'm going to bite you. He's like, no. Kiss, kiss. He's just so friendly towards me. It's kind of like how Jazz, I hand-fed Jazz, that little green lovebird right there. Butter was a pet store bird. But Butter isn't my super best friend. Like, she doesn't let me pet her. Whereas I could pet Echo a bit whenever he's in the mood. He's just agreeing with me this whole time. Jazz. Friendly little nibbles. So yeah, basically, I live in this 40-foot shipping container that's rent-free, power-free, internet-free, and I plan on doing it until I have enough money to buy my own land where I could be self-sufficient and grow my own animal food, hunt my own animal food and my own food, as well as running an animal rescue. That would be my life goal. That, I feel like, would fulfill me. So if you want to help support this YouTube, like, ambition, go ahead and subscribe. I plan on doing it with or without your support, to be quite honest. The YouTube's just a way to document this and help share it with other people. So, thank you. Check out my other videos if you haven't already. King will never stop, so take me another pill.